Hi, my name is Tim, and I can't stop thinking about stuff. A few days ago, I played D4, Dark Dreams, Don't Die, and here are my thoughts. I would like to start out by saying that I'm gonna run game footage from my stream in this video, but it will not be necessary for you to watch it. Consider this more like a podcast, and feel free to draw pretty pictures, cook delicious meals, or whatever you feel like while listening to my thoughts. My thoughts on D4, Dark Dreams, Don't Die is going to be completely spoiler-free, so no need to worry about that. Also, I'm going to give you my recommendations right up front. I don't like working on the numeric scale, so I'm using a more approve or not approve scale. I'm going to recommend D4, Dark Dreams, Don't Die, but there's a bit of a catch. The game is not complete, far from it actually. It ends on a massive cliffhanger, and the continuation of D4 Dark Dreams Don't Die is not gonna happen anytime soon. So just know that going in. In D4, you play as a detective whose wife was murdered. Her last words were, "Find D." So you investigate everyone whose name begins with the letter D. You have the ability to travel back in time when you hold different objects called mementos. The game works out mostly like an old LucasArts adventure game like Monkey Island or Grim Fandango. You walk around and investigate your surrounding, talking to people, trying to find D. D4 has an absolute ridiculous humor to it. It's over the top and then some, and it's stylized to boot. And that is the main reason why I am recommending D4 Dark Dreams Don't Die. There's just not anything like it anywhere else. Characters hitting dramatic poses, main protagonist is a beautiful sad boy who never leaves his apartment and lives with a girl who acts so much like a cat she catches a mouse with her mouth. This game is an anime, and a hysterical one at that. Games are best enjoyed unspoiled, so if you feel like playing D4 Dark Dreams Don't Die for yourself, go ahead and close down this video and give it a go. Time for my thoughts. So, as I said in D4, you play as a detective trying to find your wife's killer by going back in time using different objects called mementos. They take you back to certain key scenes related to the crime. The problem is that you have no idea what you are looking for, so you investigate everything and talk to everyone. Then, when you have solved enough puzzles and gathered enough clues, it's all summarized in a dramatic action scene that plays out like a QuickTime event. These part of the game was so much fun playing through, as the action going on is so ridiculous and over the top, I could not stop laughing. Besides those QTEs, the games play out pretty much like a point and click adventure. You will read sports articles, answer quizzes on aviation, and talk to the most colorful and eccentric people along your way. D4 is very stylish, but without losing its touch with reality. But there's a certain anime feel to it all. D4 has a very interesting, but also stupid, but entirely pointless mechanic. Everything you do drains a stamina meter. And I do mean everything. Talking to people? Drains it. Walking two steps? Drains it. Reading a magazine? Drains it. You get my point. Luckily, there's food scattered all around the place, so if you just eat a bag of chips whenever you find it, be it in the bathroom or behind a sofa, you will never have to worry about running out of stamina, making that system entirely pointless. I cannot stress this enough. D4 Dark Dreams Don't Die is nowhere finished. Not only is it not finished, but it ends on such a cliffhanger it's almost comical. And it's pretty much a guarantee that D4 will never be finished. But what is there is a total surreal experience. And if you can live with an unresolved murder case, I recommend D4 Dark Dreams Don't Die. Those were my thoughts.
Hold it! Oh.
Oh, dang it.
Gotcha. You can't escape now. This is Amanda. She just suddenly started living here one day. She sometimes goes out and gets food for us. And that's something of a lifeline for me, as I don't really go outside.